अस्सलाम वालेकुम स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज़ शबाना मीर, मैथ्स टीचर फ्रॉम एसएफ पब्लिक स्कूल। स्टूडेंट्स, इट इज़ योर फर्स्ट क्लास फॉर द सेशन 2020-21 एंड यू आर गोइंग टू लर्न अ न्यू टॉपिक ऑफ मैथ्स। बिफोर टू स्टार्ट आवर टॉपिक, आई वुड लाइक टू शेयर एन एक्टिविटी विद यू। डू यू नो व्हाट इज़ द मीनिंग ऑफ एन एक्टिविटी? It means you will have to think hard and try to answer it. So we can say that it is a thinking game. Let's play this thinking game together. We have activity number one here. Make different sets using these balls. Students, can you see that we have red balls, blue balls and yellow balls? You can also see big balls and small balls in this picture. I will put all the balls of the same color in one set. Students, can you tell me what does that mean? It means that we can put the two blue balls in one set like this. Then I will put all the yellow balls in one set like this and all the red balls in another set like this. In this way we have made three different sets of balls. Now I will put the big balls in one set and the small balls in another set. You can see all the small balls in one set like this. There are three red balls, two yellow balls and one blue ball in one set. Now I will put big balls in another set like this. You can see two red balls, two yellow balls and the blue ball in one set. Students, you have made two different sets of balls in this activity. Now let's play another activity. Activity number two. In the given picture, can you see the lovely drawings? We have some flowers, an apple, a strawberry and a banana. Now let's circle set of flowers. In that mean, you have to draw a circle around all the flowers together. So you can use pencil to draw a circle around the flowers only. In this way, you have a set of flowers. In this picture, you can see the set of insects. So, students, what did you learn from these activities? You learned that how to make sets. Students, now I am going to start a very interesting and a simple topic of maths, introduction to sets. In this topic, students will be able to learn about the concept of sets, about set notation and its forms like descriptive and tabular method, how to represent a set, and about different types of sets. First, I am going to define about set. What is a set? A set is a collection of well-defined and distinct objects. For example, the set of vowels of the English alphabet. As you all know, the vowels of English alphabets are A, E, I, O, U. So, a set is a well-defined collection of objects. What do you mean by well-defined collection of objects? If we define a particular set, suppose the set of planets in the solar system, we don't have any doubt which planets are there in the solar system. But if I asked you define a good football player, which player will belong to that set? It's a big question, because you may find somebody a good player, but in case of another person, he may not be a good player. It depends on personal choice, so can be vary to person to person. The set of planets in the solar system is a well-defined set. We all know there are 8 planets in the solar system, which is true for every person or every situation. Now you can tell me, what is a set? Set is a well-defined collection of objects. Well-defined collection of objects can be the planets of the solar system. As we all know that there are 8 planets in the solar system. Similarly, the colors of the rainbow. We all know there are 7 colors in the rainbow, which are violet, indigo, blue, green, yellow, orange, and red. And any color rather than those is not an element of rainbow. Similarly, the capital city of Pakistan is a well-defined set. And the set of vowels of the English alphabets is also a well-defined set and true for all. While a set of interesting books, favorite food items for children, good students of class 6, and favorite flavors of ice creams are not well-defined set, because these are depend on personal choice. Students, now I am going to tell you that how to represent a set and how to write a set. For example, I write all the colors of rainbow. Let me name the set with capital letter as C, and all the elements will be written in curly brackets. And these brackets are also known as braces. If I write all colors, they will be written as. Look at this set. C is the name of set, then equal sign, then braces. And all the elements are written within the brackets. V for violet, I for indigo, B for blue, G for green, Y for yellow, O for orange, and R for red. These 7 colors are the elements of the set C. No other color can belong to rainbow. So, C is the set of colors of rainbow. Students, you have learned now how to represent a set. C is the name of set, and braces are used to enclose all the elements of the set. The object in a set are called elements or members of the set. For example, set of 3 balls denoted by set B. And you can see in the circle, 3 names are here, Hassan, Irfan, and Shahid. Hassan is the element of set B. There is another example. Here, V is the element of set C, and written as V belongs to set C. Element. This symbol is epsilon. It means is an element of. Is not element of. So this is how to represent a set. If we write peach color, it is not an element of set C. So if we cross this epsilon sign, it actually becomes not an element of. Students, what did you learn? You have learned what is a set, then how to represent a set, and you also learned how to represent an element of a set. After this, now I am going to tell you how to write or find the elements of a set. Number 1, descriptive method. In this method, we actually define a set in proper words. For example, I want to write vowels of the English alphabets. Then I will write like this. Set A is the set of vowels of the English alphabet. There is another method by which we can represent a set. It is called a tabular method. Tabular method, if you want to write a set of natural numbers less than 9, then I will write like this. Set A is equals to numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. These numbers are less than 9. This method is called a tabular method. Students, now I am telling you some special types of set. finite set. A finite set contains a limited number of elements. For example, set of days in a week. You can count there are 7 days in a week. Number 2 is finite set. An infinite set is a set which contains unlimited number of objects. Like 2, 4, 6, 8, 10 to onwards, you cannot count all the even numbers. Number 3 is empty set. An empty set is a set that contains no elements. It is also called a null set. Number 4, universal set. A universal set is a set which contains all the sets under consideration. For example, set U is equals to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Set A is equals to 2, 4 and 6. You can see the elements of set A, 2, 4, 6 are belongs to set U, and B equal 1, 7, 9, and all the elements of set B belongs to set U. That's why set U is the universal set. Students, now I am going to start exercise 1.1. Look, question number 1. The elements of set P are 1, 2, 3, 4. And the elements of set Q are A, B, C, D. Now you have to fill the blanks. The number 1. The element 2 belongs to set P. In number 2, A belongs to set Q. In number 3, G is not belongs to set Q. In number 4, 5 is not belongs to set P. In number 5, D belongs to set Q. In number 6, 3 is not belongs to set Q. Question number 2, list the elements of the following sets. The number 1, counting numbers less than right. Students, you have to write all the numbers less than 10. The answer is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. In number 2 question, you have to write vowels in the word image. In the word image, how many vowels are there? The vowels are I, A, E. In number 3, you have to write color of the national flag. As we know, the colors of the national flags are white and green. In number 4, you have to write all the numbers less than 25 and which are divisible by 5. As you know, 5 you can divide by 5, 10, 15 and 20 are the numbers which are divisible by 5. Number 5, multiples of 3 less than 15. What are the multiples of 3? You have to write the table of 3. The elements are 3, 6, 9 and 12. These numbers are less than 15 and the multiples of 3. Question number 3. Write the following sets in the tabular form. Number 1, set M. In the braces you can see here X. X is an element where X is the name of the presidents of Pakistan. It means you have to write all the names of the presidents of Pakistan. Like Iskandar Mirza, Ayub Khan, Yahya Khan, General Zia-ul Haq, Farooq Lighari, Parvez Musharraf, Asif Ali Zardari, Mamnoon Hussain are the presidents of Pakistan. In number 2, you have to write the numbers less than 6, which are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Look at number 3 part. In this set, you have to write the multiples of 3. Do you know what are the multiples of 3? 3, 6, 9 are the multiples of 3. In number 4, you have to write all the even numbers less than 10. As we know, all what are the even numbers? All the numbers which can divided by 2 are called the even numbers, and you have to write all the even numbers less than 10. What are these numbers? These numbers are 2, 4, 6 and 8. In number 5, you have to write the number which are divisible by 3 and less than 20. Do you know which numbers can we divide by 3? Yes, we can divide by 3, 6, 9, 12, 15 and 18. These numbers are divisible by 3. In number 6, you have to write all the planets of the solar system. As we know, there are 8 planets in the solar system, and these are Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, Neptune. In number 7, you have to write the name of 3 countries beginning with B. And these are Bhutan, Bangladesh and Belgium. Look at question number 4. Write the following sets in tabular form. Number 1. Set of days in a week. As we all know, there are 7 days in a week and names are written here. Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday and Saturday. In number 2, you have to write set of even numbers between 12 and 21. As you know, even numbers are divisible by 2. So 14, 16, 18 and 20 are the even numbers between 12 and 21. Number 3, set of odd numbers between 10 and 20. As we know, odd numbers are those numbers which are not divisible by 2. So 11, 13, 15, 17 and 19 are odd numbers between 10 and 20. Number 4, set of the first 5 planets. Same 5 planets are here. In number 5, set of the cities of Pakistan beginning with K. Karachi, Kohat and Khuzdar are the cities which are beginning with K. Now look at the question number 5. Mark a list of finite sets, infinite sets and empty sets from the following. Number 1, the set of universities in Lahore. Number 2, set of whole numbers. Number 3, set of negative integers. Number 4, set of whole numbers between 9 and 10. Number 5, set of names of months beginning with K. Number 6, the set of vowels of the alphabets. It's your homework. Try yourself. Do practice of all the above questions and write in your math notebook. Thank you and Allah Hafiz.